we're working hard to keep you healthy in this next report. Last night, we took you through the painful journey of a local woman here in the middle of fighting breast cancer. What we didn't tell you is that if she would have only had a mammogram, it would not have detected the cancer. And so we found two new tools that can help you fight cancer before it's ever detected.
I know it's something out there lurking.
More and more women.
I think about that. Will I live to see my grandchildren? Will I live to see my sons marry?
Are looking for other tools to fight breast cancer before it strikes.
I do have a daughter who is 15, and I want to be here for her.
Vicky, Cindy, and Deb are cousins. They've lost four family members to breast cancer, including an uncle.
I lost my mother 6 years ago in September to breast cancer.
My mother was not at my wedding because she had passed away.
But it's been this dark cloud hanging over all of us.
So for the last 2 years, these women have gotten their mammograms and something called thermal imaging. They swear by it.
It tells me there's a storm brewing.
Thermography picks up the heat in a woman's breast where potentially cancerous cells can form. Critics say it gives too many false positives. But Dr. Lisa Allen,
I think it may be the wave of the future,
is seeing life-saving results. She says thermography can detect cancer long before you'd ever feel a lump or see it in a mammogram.
One of the limitations for mammography, if the woman's young or if they have very dense breasts, mammogram is not very useful. This one can.
Look at this. The image Dr. Allen is showing us is a woman who in 2004 got a mammogram that was negative. The next year, the thermal imaging camera detected she was at a high risk for developing cancer.
The yellow and the red, that's warmer.
And sure enough, within a year, this patient was diagnosed with breast cancer.
It picks it up while something is changing in the body.
Before the cancer is there.
Before the cancer is there.
And it's not just what's going on in your body. Now your family tree can save your life.
How you can go back and trace these things back several generations.
Dr. Patricia Brining, a radiologist at Christ, says that if you have a strong family history of cancer, you need to consider genetic testing.
That can really help people to plan their future and what they need to do.
Genetic testing is expensive and isn't for everyone, but if this is you.
Bilateral cancers, cancer at a young age, cancer in multiple generations in a family.
Genetic counselor Aaron Miller says it's worth the money.
Do what you can to prevent it.
And for Vicky, Cindy, and Deb, their only fear has been breast cancer. But Aaron says genetic testing can also detect other cancers lurking in your body that you haven't even thought about.
We may identify that you're actually at risk for ovarian cancer as well, and you might not otherwise know that.
Genetic testing and thermal imaging, two more tools to detect breast cancer before it's too late.
I think about all the time, what can I do different that my mother and them didn't get the chance to do?
And you know, there's so much varying information out there. I have to wonder, should we do this sort of testing instead of a mammogram, or are we talking about in addition to?
No, it's really in addition to, and we want to stress that all the doctors we talk to still say, look, mammograms first and foremost, mm-hmm. but this is one more tool that you can do maybe before a mammogram might pick it up. But again, make sure you do everything you can, especially if you have a strong family history. And you know what, a lot of people also asking me a lot about the cost. We should mention that thermography costs about $140. Genetic testing, on the other hand, a lot more expensive. It can cost something like $1,500, even a couple of $1,000s.
All right, very expensive. But when you're talking about your health,
it's worth every penny.
Okay, yeah. All right, good information there.